Welcome back to part 3 of this Graveyard Keeper early game. So last time we upgraded our church quite a bit and made a very good second sermon. And right now my goal is mainly to unlock a few technologies. So what I want is here, assembly so I can make jointing. I want to unlock iron casting so that I can make a steel part and all of the glass related technology. No, first step is I want to take woodcutter and go and gather some wood. I don't have to use all of the phase that I just got. I can wait for that. And maybe I want to go and cut some trees so they start to grow back. Cabbage anymore. And I'm just planting a little bit more wheat this time. Just some wedge and some firewood because I actually don't have enough things to study. And as well some glue because I can use the old one I have. Thank you. taking with me anything that I can study that will give me some red point. Consuming enough paper so I have enough science points. So first, of course, I want to study all of the body parts that I have not studied so far, which will take me 8 phase in total. Then all of my tools. This one, the chaos solution doesn't require any phase, so only requires one science point, and then everything that brings me red point, which is all of the wood parts that I can make, the stone, and all of the iron part, simple, complex, and the nail. Those points we can unlock iron casting, and we don't even have enough red point to unlock that, so as you can see, we still have a good way to go to craft everything we want. In the meantime, we'll start by cutting a lot of wood billets. Thank you. So right now I'm waiting for time to pass because I need to go see the farmer and the merchant. In the meantime, I'm already going to craft 18 iron pot. I need 2x4 to upgrade both furnace to furnace 3. And I also want to expand the workyard because I start to be. I won't have enough space to build everything I want. But I also want to upgrade the carpenter workbench, but before that I just want to craft 15 planks. And before you upgrade the carpenter workbench, it brings you 2 red points, and once you have upgraded it costs a little bit less energy to transform them, but they only bring you 1. Here, 4 and 4. And as this one is done, I can expand here. And as you can see, we are almost out of luck already. And it's midday, so I want to go see the farmer and see the merchant. Remember to take 1 Hiccup Grass with you and all of the vegetables. I still need 4 more beetroot, but instead of waiting for that, because today's day where I actually want them, I'm just going to buy them by the farmer. Actually sold him so much firewood that it's not there's a value of 0, which is why it doesn't give me any money, but when you sell it to him it still has value, so it will still improve his total wealth, which will be enough to get him unlocked to tier 2 and 3. And I want tier 2 because I need the onion seed. Here's our friend the merchant, and be very careful here. You have during the dialogue about the garden, one of the few quest dialogue in Graveyard Keeper, but depending on the choice of dialogue you use, that will have a different outcome. So here, if you choose deal, you will have to bring him some vegetable, and if you choose no way, you have to pay him 1 gold. So of course we want to take the vegetable. And of course, we could have started CC here, but mainly what I want is to buy some grape seed. I just take the opportunity to empty out my chest at home. And then here we want to take precious metals so that we can craft some graphite, and I want 10 of them and 2 more for this one. And here currently our morgue is full, so I want to craft some wood billet so that I can burn everybody that is inside to have the donkey bring me more. Just make sure that I can upgrade this one and put it to work to something else. Always take the flesh and the skull, because of course you will need a lot of skull to decorate the ritual place, and you will need some meat as well to make some burger. The rest of the organ for now I don't care. And blood of course, because blood fat are so valuable. Some skin. start to unlock some to make some glass, and I recommend that you unlock the tech before, because normally you harvest 5 sand from the sand pile on the river, but if you have the last tech of glassmaking, instead of 5 you harvest 10 each time. Just save you some time. At this point, normally you should have more than enough carrot with 8 garden plot. So if you want, you can also give some of your carrot to the refugee camp so they start to build happiness. My next step is I need to harvest some more stone, harvest a little bit of iron and a little bit of more coal. And for that, of course, I need to set up the quarry, which will cost me 33 flitches, 9 simple iron board, 20 nails, and some wood. I generally make 150, so I don't have to make much more for a good amount of time. And I want to make off my furnace and start working on something else. So normally this should both be done, and by the time I'm done with that, and I can put them on something productive in the meantime. One store stockpile, one ore stockpile, of stone will be sufficient. To infinite, so that you don't have to click each time you want to mine some other block, and then drop all the extra wedge I have here. And of course I have unlocked precious metal, which means I can, so the chances are quite low to get some silver, quite probable, and some gold. I don't really need any of it. Silver would be nice to get a little bit, to make a little bit of money. But I don't have the tech, and I don't will not have the 100 red point necessary to unlock it very soon. We have more urgent tech to unlock. And so I want 12. Block 14 stone. Well, there is too much, just start to put them on the pile. Thank you. iron ore. Avoid 80 stone. And just a little bit more coal, and we'll be all set for a good amount of time. Soon, but for now we'll only need two. And I recommend you make two chisels because every time you make one, as the one you use drop out of your pocket, and if you have two, you can keep making without having to wait in between. I'm just going to put a little bit of order out of everything in that source chest because not to get a little bit too much in one chest. Okay, now for the next part I will want to prepare everything to make all of the alchemy station. And for that, the first part, I need a lot of compact iron part to make beam and then make them into jointing. Eight features. because I don't have that much log, I will be making the planks directly. Like I said, once you upgrade it, only give you one red. So here, steel cog, complex iron bolt, simple nail, conical flask, jointing, some polished stone, planks, out of stone, 40 to be precise, and that's not enough flinches. I need 6 more. Where exactly you make them doesn't really matter. I prefer to put them in that area. So we want a storage and a mixer. Thank you. miscalculated something somewhere. Not that bad. You can never have too much. And here, of course, I'm a little in advance. I need to wait for the summon. In the meantime, I'm just going to drop everything extra I have. Ooh, and of course, you will need peat to make the fertilizer. All of the bush here, because each of them gives you 5 red points, and the next few takes we unlock will take a lot of red points. Yeah, we'll just do the summon and show exactly what I'm studying directly. So here we have an 88% chance of a success in the summon, which means that it's not guaranteed. But 98 is quite a good odds. I don't really want to lose some time saving for that. But of course, it does mean that it could fail. And would get quite a lot less face if that's the case. Now, of course, we don't have all the candles that we had last time, so it's not as much fate as we had. Just 18, which is 10 less than what we did have last week. Of course. Okay, so first part, I need some blue point, so I will be studying of the stand, so the gravestone decoration. Then I want to study the maggot. Basically, I'm going to study things that I will use for alchemy. So I need hemp to make some acceleration powder. I need some pickup grass. And I need some mushroom. And what we want is simple fertilizer and complex fertilizer, for which I need exactly 3 more. No, unfortunately, none of everything you can do here give you point, but you can study acceleration powder for no face, which will give you 5. If you have a little bit less, you can also study something else, like but we have like ash. It's not necessary to study ash, but this can give you more points if you need. And so the recipe I want to make, I will just show you which recipe I want to use, exactly which ingredients. Basically, I'm grinding a lot of what I have. And I'm a little bit strike than I should have been. Transforming the maggot into life extract. Now we are quite limited by the amount of peat we have. Quite quickly. Here I also want to grind the brain and fat. Fortunately, slow extract is quite hard to make. Outside of fat, there is not that many sources, and none of which I have access to right now except buying it. The Acup grass, you don't need that much elf solution, just a few to make some elf potion. And the mushroom, which are a key ingredient in for our fertilizer. I'm just going to show you which recipe I make, and I will stop here. So the first one is we want to mix acceleration powder and slowing solution. Here, unfortunately, we would need to also go and get some more, because you need to make 2, 4, 6 of them, because you need 2 of them for each speed. Speed fertilizer that you make. The next one is ash. Oh no, that's on the advanced table. We want to mix ash, toxic solution from the mushroom, and life extract. And the last two, which are not necessary to make right now, but that's salt. Oh, that's white powder, not salt. Where is salt? So salt and elf solution. That's for the merchant. You still need to go and talk to Clotho before you can actually give the spice to the merchant. And as well for that, I will need life powder and elf solution. And this will make a life potion. Have more okay, so I can see if you need to study something else, don't hesitate to do it. You have more than enough. And the main reason why I'm doing all of that early is just so that I can make as much of cis fertilizer and cis fertilizer here, because the sooner you can make both of them, the sooner you can start to multiply and grow your own grapes, which are generally like the key part of progressing the game. Just make money, because the 12 gold units for the aristocrat paper are the hardest part to achieve, and the best way to do that is through selling wine. And those two fertilizer together really speed up the time it takes you to get out of gold wine going. So Igor, let me know if you want to for me to do a part 4. I don't have really that much more to explain from here. It should be quite straightforward. Specifically, it's open in terms of what you want to do. If you want to, like, I'm mainly doing that for the speedrun, where I don't care for most of the questline. Like, I'm not going to improve the refugee camp generally, or progress into any other questlines that I don't need. So I'd just be progressing through the tavern and the main game questline. But you have still a lot of faith. You have, in terms of technology, like, we can make almost everything we want. We have almost all technology and luck, very few. The only part that are really missing is marble and all of the quality of life technology, but in terms of like what percentage of technology we have open, that's almost everything. So it's only like day 18 and we are already done for a big part of the progression of the game. So let me know if you want more, and I'll see you next time.